Alright, this is Glenn Zeno. I'm coming to you live from the house of flowing drinks and rockin' tunes, gents. And we're about to kick some shit from the Doomer Boards crew. And we're going to be playing the Doomer Boards project's number fucking 20. And it is called Dungeons and Demons. So go and get your D20s out, get your dice, roll them up, throw them against the wall, throw them at your neighbor, throw them at your little sister, your little brother, because they're little cunts, and let's do this shit. Now, this project has been led by my dear choice bro from across the ditch called Vertigo. And it's pretty fucking cool. Oh, shit, don't smoke, kiddies. Now, I'm going to get into this shit real quick, but after that sound-checking excitement, my scotch has run low. So we're just going to have a word from our sponsors, and then we're going to get right into DBP 20, Dungeons and Demons. Let's do this fucking shit.
Egad, someone has besmirched my reputation in the Doom community. To the keyboard, I've got the perfect plan to take these Doomer Boards troublemakers down. Without their Discord, they'll be helpless. There's no way this plan could backfire.
Hey, my crew will do it to you dirty. This a boss fight, bitch, we on map 30. I got the sick flow, call it S-Fall. We wrote the Bible on this Doom shit, Tom Hall. It's DB crew for life, give me the scythe and I'll slice them up nice, you damn right. You done fucked up now, kid. We rise from the underground, do it like it did. Smoking on strong mids, turn you to fresh gibs. Sit laughing at you, take up a bit behind the wall where the AV is hid. My sound blast overtaking your ad lib. Oh, I'm a incel, how? I got three bitches with me in the booth right now. This whole shit ain't allowed. I got the molded drip, son. You best go down.
Oh no, Billy, you were supposed to be one of the nice ones. What have I done? Oh no!
Still, representing for the DB crew.
Still,
killing your old school CL2.
Still,
we on the grind with the DBPs. Check the first of the month for the new release.
It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. I come out now. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life.
Oh, Billy, I can't wait to play the new Doomer Boards project. Can you give me a sneak peek?
Yeah, girl.
But I map too.
I had to clap back. Where your maps at? We give the people what they need like a backpack. You don't know the code, but I'm Carmac. The sad fact is you're all decay, no attack. Try to make a scene like Tarantino. I'm sipping scotch, hanging with Glenn Zeno. It's just B-I-double-L. Mappers is washed up, leave them on the shores of hell. My team's Romero and your team is Willits. SSG cock for your whiny-ass children. 100% killing these mappers be lily white, feed them to Lil. If you can't fuck with my crew, then mofos be slimy. Toxin refinery mindset, we grinded. First of the month, kill you all ultra-violently. BFG to the dome silently.
Hey guys, wait, come back to the Discord. I'll make a map for the next DBP. I'll let you use some of my Neon DM resources.
Still,
representing for the DB crew.
Still,
killing your old school CL2.
Still,
we on the grind with the DBBs. Check the first of the month for the new release.
The board's back, y'all.
Yo, I don't even need to be on this track anymore. I just killed that motherfucker. Come on, ladies. Let's go do a little, playtesting. You know what I'm saying.
Okay, just give me some of that BFD.
Oh. Shout out to Glenn Zeno. Shout out to Cuppy. Shout out Scrang, Bert, Memphis, Gassy,
it's a Doomer Boards crew.
Everybody
for life
out there, it's doing it for the
Boards
culture.
Crew for life. I come out now. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. 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 I come out now. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. 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 I come out now. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life. It's a Doomer Boards crew for life.
Big ol' Billy style.
Alright, that was Big Old Billy with the Tom Hall drip. He's a talented motherfucker, that one. I love him to death. Alright, are you still with me, Verd? Am I still working or what? Excellent. All right, now we're gonna get straight into this. Now, I already demoed the first release candidate in PR Boom, so I'm gonna go for some sexy GZ Doom today with GL Death's courtesy of Phobos, and it's gonna make Zizzy's map a hell of a lot fucking easier. So let's do this shit. First, we'll see the beautiful glory of the title screen. I've got to turn the music back up. A solid 8 maps in this DBP. By a solid 8 mappers. Now let's get this shit underway. I'll have my save scum at the ready. Dooma Boards crew for life. That's the Dooma Boards crew for life. Alright, our first map is Crypt. Comes from our great Italian friend, Walter Confalonieri. Now Walter's a little tight in the health in his map, so I better just try and pay attention to what I'm doing. Because I'm already down to 19, and there ain't really much scope for more health. I'm probably going to die very quickly right now. But we'll take that as one for the fallen, if I do. Yep, I knew it. I knew it. I'm a Nostradamus. Check that shit out. Now in this DBP, we have some lovely shades of purple. The green is fantastic as well. Every DBP brings a new kind of color scheme and theme that just ties it all together, makes it all stand out from the previous ones. Yeah, the torches look sick with the lights of Earth. I'm still gonna die on 13 health, this is fucked. How long is it gonna take me to make it out of the first area on Walt's map? Let's see. One health, oh. It's only gonna take one little shot from that chain gunner over there. Oh, avoided that one. Yeah, shit. All right, serious time. Serious like Nick Kyrgios, let's go. Alright, I think I better save here after the very first room. I know it's manly, but I gotta do it. Let's have some scotch for good luck. Oh man, that was pretty dumb. Oh, that's really dumb. You can tell I've been playing Doom for fucking 25 years, isn't it? 25 years and I still suck. Let's go. Alright, I think we can make it now. Hit scanners again. Alright, now we're rocking and rolling. Alright, so Walt's done a nice little voidy kind of thing with his theme, and although his texturing's a little basic at times, and we do get on his case, but in a nice way, because he's a good dude, You know, I think it all works pretty well. Sets what's coming ahead. It is clean. The texture's clean. Oh, Vert fixed that texture. Good on you, bro. Good on you, bro. Looks nice. Walt gets the job done, basically. Nothing fancy. He's not going to blow you away, but he gets the job done, and he brings the fun. Now, while I am doing GZ Doom, I still do the good old horizontal axis and auto aim, because I'm an old fart like that. I've forgotten something. What did I feel? Oh yeah, the purple key is lowered over there. And yeah, like I said, I was saying, it is kind of like basic texturing, but I find this visual pretty striking enough that I used it in his vault scenery behind his name in the credit map. It just stands out. That shit just stands out. Sometimes less is more. Actually, a lot of the time, less is more. Just keep that in mind. I walked right into that one. Could have sworn there was a Hell Knight over here. And no, there he is over there. I did not mean to do that. Nice. Alright, good shit. Alright, now we got this map unlocked in, and we're gonna kick this shit. Some excellent MIDI choices in this project. I'm really digging this in GZ, where it just adds something to the sound. Some very good quality sound playback it has, and through the headphones, it's pretty fucking sick. I'm using the... I had some weird settings. I wasn't utilizing GZ Doom to its potential. And I asked Phobos for some recommendations, and these are the settings he gave me, and fuck, it's real nice. Look at the shadows everywhere. It's a real pretty port. Now there is a secret right there. Beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah, I got that secret actually the first time I tested this map. I was struggling for ages trying to get that armor like earlier on in the map, in the playthrough, and I'm just like, shit, how am I gonna get that shit, man? And I gave up on it. Then I got to that spot and I looked at the little, what is it? It's a little fucking cow or bull head on that texture, and I just pressed it and bang, and I'm like, yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty fucking good. And I think we're gonna exit this map with 100% everything. Yeah, fucking nice. 100% everything. Strange map, because it can kill you very fucking quickly with lack of health and ammunition at the very beginning. But once you get a foothold, it's tough. But, you know, it's got its little spice. But you can get through it very well. So there we go, 100% everything on the crypt by Walter C. 5 minutes, 51 seconds, not counting the deaths. I'm going to shout out to this interpick, which was... I don't know, was this from DMDR? This was from DMDR. It's really fucking nice. It's got that old school Monkey Island or Prince of Persia kind of graphical feel going on with it. Alright, map 2. Speak of DMDR, I think it's his next. Seller of the Stargazer. Let's expect spiral staircases and lowering floors. It's another one of those maps that can kill you really quick in the beginning. But once you get a foothold, you can just get by. Alright, save scum, let's do this shit. This is a MIDI track that wasn't in the pack that DMDR chose himself, and he's made a fucking good choice, I have to say. Nice and creepy and dungeony and demony. Good shit, bro. I believe their first secret is over here. Double secret, nice. Probably a little bit of overkill, but that's alright. I didn't find this one, but I assume you can get up there because I can see a medikit. How are we going to do that? Not from there. Carry on. Oh. Hit the switch, Glenn Zinger. Oh, nice. Yeah, those glows and the health potions are fucking nice. Phobos is a dude, man. Nice, I've handled it pretty well. I usually get my ass handed to me half and half the time over here. Alright, cool. Doing well. Hey, yellow skull. Say, that didn't kill you, did it, DMDR? It didn't hurt, man. That's all pretty cool. For those who don't know, DMDR is very against putting a skull key in his map for whatever reason, to the point where he's put it on the fucking auto map. I like him, he's a funny cunt. Skull keys suck balls. DBK for life. But he got it. He fucking got it. He did it. He caved into the peer pressure. It's not peer pressure. It's fucking... It suited the project, man. Like, everything's a skull. There's nothing fucking tech to fucking have, like, the normal keycard. I'm not usually a skull kind of dude myself, but... Look at this fucking fiend, man. He can't have fucking, like, modern fucking keycards and that shit. Whether you hate the cunts or not. There's a lot of shit I hate in Doom, but I put it in just because it fucking works, man. Just do that shit. It's so ominous. I know nothing's going on, but you just know something's going to happen pretty soon. And you're just waiting for it. There we go. I know there's another secret around here too. I don't want to miss it because it's actually a better weapon from memory. I did it in my PR Boon demo yesterday. It's not here yet, or I've missed it. Top points for everyone who put barrels in their maps. I struggle to use them myself, but I love to fucking shoot them. There we go, here comes the beef. This is such a great mid texture. I never saw it before this set. Fuck, I love it. Gives me a Japanese kind of feel. Some wooden exploding barrels, eh? Like Bill said, he's got some from DBP09, and they actually have an orange liquid in them, so it might work really well. So they're kind of, yeah, brown, they've got a couple of metal bands around them, and they've got orange liquid on top. It'll suit the set pretty well. Just check out the ones from DBP09, Legend of the Hidden Tech. Which we almost went with a sequel for this month, but we've come up with something else, actually. The old evil dungeon master, Big Old Billy. I'm not going to say what it is, because he actually hasn't launched the fucking project yet, even though it's like, well, it's the fourth in Australia, it's probably just ticked over to the third in America. But we all know Bill, he doesn't do anything before the fourth of the month, whether launching projects or releasing them. His calendars, all the calendars he buys, I don't know what shop he goes to, but it never has the first, second, or third day of the month. But this is Bill, man, so we'll forgive him costing us a few days to make our maps, because we know we'll get it done, it'll be a sick project. But I can safely say the theme that he's gone for is sick, it's timely, it's been discussed about recently in the community, and it's going to be a lot of fucking fun. And Legend of the Hidden Tech Season 2 will be coming soon to a cable service provider near you. Just not next month. Or this month. It still is February. Alright, now that was the secret I was looking for, but what did it open? I think I have to go back down here. Or is that just the access to the next part? I'm missing a bloody secret that I really want. I'm sure it's a rocket launcher or something. I think I'm just gonna have to suck it up. Oh, there it is. Oh, that's a sneaky little low switch. Oh, and it's the Plasma Wizard Hands. Now, this is one of the stars of this set, the Plasma Replacement. In all effect, it's still a plasma rifle, but just the feel of it when you're using it, it really has a life of its own and brings its own thing. So much so that I start my map, which is number 8, with that at the very beginning of the map. That's the first thing you do. You pick up. It adds a lot to the magic element of the dungeons and demons theme. There's another little sneaky secret over here too. Which opens the lift to... Oh, I keep fucking up this lift and it's something obvious. It's really close. There it is. Ah, the rocket launcher as well. Alright, now we're in good shape. Good shape to tackle the exit area. Alright. Now DMDR is a relatively new recent mapper. come onto the scene, join the crew. I think his first release map was in DVP-16, which is Sybe's Freaky Colonoscopy. And he did it so nice, he did it twice and put out a second one, and they were really fucking good for first release maps. And what we're about to see here is starting to become one of his trademarks, and that's the circular kind of stair kind of thing, but then lowers later on. I like it. It's one of the best things you do in Doom. Lower a floor. Who doesn't love a lowering floor? Oh yeah, check that shit out. Now we can see the GL devs come into their own with the plasma wizard hands. Fantastic stuff. Rev rocket in the back. That's no fun. And everything else lowers. Just to make it interesting. Now we see the first appearance in the set of one of the all-time greatest Mancubus replacements. The Purple Golem. Check that shit. I'm just gonna let them drain each other for a while, run around like a drunk fool. Because I'm kind of a half drunk fool. Well, I am right now at this point in time, but I'm not gonna let that stop me. There we go. Something's still lowering. Alright. Four of seven secrets. I know there's one left right in the very exit room, but there's a couple I'm missing on this map, and one of them is the tomato secret. So I don't think we're going to see it because I don't think I picked it up yet again. Hang on, what the hell is that? Something's going on in there. Alright, let's make sure I pick up everything. Last two monsters. And there is a secret over here somewhere. There it is. Now this secret, this is one of my favorite secrets, is to have that little sliver of switch lever. So there's a man after my own heart there. Now here's a little message telling you to go back. Because if you don't, not that it matters, this will warp you back to the beginning of the map. Warp you to the very beginning of the map. But we'll go back because I don't know where the other two secrets are. I'm not going to try it. And that is it for this map, I think. Cellar of the Stargazer. Yep, exactly how I played it yesterday. I'm missing two secrets. I'm going to have to find them in a later day. I'm just going to go for a quick bathroom break, refill my glass, and I'm going to get on to map 3, which is Rotten Initiative from the man, the lead himself, the man from Auckland, Vertigo. Alright, my scotch is full again. I'm just gonna have a quick smoke before I get in the bird smart. If anyone wants to talk some shit or type some shit to the chat over there, I can answer back. Or not. So Bert's dropped his map pretty late again due to a hardware mishap where he lost 4 days of work, but I think the end result turned out really good and Bert's improving his mapping craft all the time, and this is definitely his best map to date, and it's fucking pretty tough. Pretty tough, it's short and sweet, but there's some moments that'll fuck you right up if you're not paying attention. And yeah, the dude is fucking doing very well. Already, yeah. He's got some juicy secrets in this, which I'm gonna have pleasure liberating their items from. Short and tough, man. Or shot, man. It is shot. I mean, Bert teaches me some really cool Kiwi slang all the time. I only used to know shit like choice and jandals and LMPs. But Bert's got some of that new age Kiwi shit we don't hear over here. Well, yeah, I only did pistol start myself, Bert, when I tested your map originally, when you sent it to me, that Arvo, and yesterday when I did the PR Boom demo. So, yeah, well, I know how it plays in pistol start as well, but that archwile makes for a tough beginning, but I've probably got enough weaponry now to sort of, you know, to nerf him a bit, but it's just the positioning more so. Sometimes you can have all the ammo and weapons in the world, but it's all about the positioning and how you have to attack the monster, how you have to position yourself from the other threats around, and that makes all the difference. Yeah, I will fuck that RV right up. I will, bro. But I have to fucking take care of the other, his mates first. You can't just stand here and just, you know, and just fucking plonk away at him. But that's what I mean. You're like, sometimes there's an abundance of ammo, but if you've got the right positioning, all the ammo in the world ain't gonna help. And I think this is a good setup, a continuous, but we're gonna find out in about 1 minute after I finish sucking down this smoke. My favorite AV setup you've got in this map is when you're in the room and you've got to press a switch in the far wall to keep opening the door. And the way you've got to fight it and tackle it, that the door always closes, well, at least once. And that AV is behind the door, and he's resurrecting monsters while you're fucking stuck behind the door. So just when you think you got him, the door closes, then you got to run back to the switch, you open the door, and he's resurrecting something else. That's a fucking great setup, and I'm going to try and steal it sometime. That's it, bro. Steal each other's shit. It's all recycling. It's good for the environment. Good for the Doom environment. Let's do that shit. All right, now I'm ready to do it. Time to stop lollygagging and piss farting around. Let's do this shit. Rotten initiative. Motherfucker, he's targeting me already. That's what I mean, Bert. All the ammo in the world, but he's locked on me already. Oh shit, and I forgot about those too. Yeah, nice and tough, man. Nice and tough. You know what? I don't have all the weaponry in the world. I fucking spent all the... I do have the plasma and rocket, but I got no fucking ammo for it. All right, run, 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 run. That's good with the Kakko providing like backup attack right there too, dude. All right, sweet. Beautiful. Nice secret. A Doom classic. When you just have the same texture but different colored. Very good. An old fave. That one never goes out of fashion. Another great music track that Jay-Z Doom really brings out really well. Take care of the secret first. Good secret, good secret. Any secret with a soul sphere is really fucking good fun. Great pleasures in Doom is just mowing down zombie monsters with the fucking chain gun. That'll never go out of fashion. Megasphere secret, very good, very good. Another good Doom secret, fucking very good, very good. You fit that many shotgunners in this little room, man, but it fucking works well. Right, here we are at the room in question. Just gonna hit this cunt with an axe. There we go. All the pretty lights, that's some good shit. Yeah, there we go. Here's that setup we're talking about. Yeah, excellent, excellent. That's a fucking great setup. Nice, I did well that time. First few times were a little rough. Thank you. I was having this discussion with Bill about sprite replacements. And basically you can, what is the last secret? Basically with sprite replacements, it's, you can just change the graphic. You don't have to change any dehack or anything like that. It'll change the speed of the projectile or whatever. But the size of it makes it appear faster. Like we have this imp here, which shoots that kind of electric green crossbow projectile. And it just appears faster than a normal imp fireball. Although nothing has changed about it, just the size. So the smaller the replacement, the faster it appears. And the larger, if you make a replacement that is larger than the original sprite, it will look slower. Which we can sort of tell with in Alien Bastards with the Cyber Demon and the rockets. Like, it's the exact same. Nothing's changed in physics, but just the size of it compared to the original sprite, it just looks slower and it just changes the feel. It's very subtle, but it's a very, very good touch and something good to keep in mind when you're just changing things. And you don't have to go and fuck with the mechanics or anything, but just keep in mind, like, the original sprite, if it's smaller, your replacement, it's going to be faster. If it's larger, it's going to be slower. This is a very good trick, and you don't have to fuck with the basic core mechanics at all and just get a totally different feel that way. All right, let's finish this one. Vert, dude, did he catch all these untextured sectors over here? Oh yeah, he's done good. How about your exit sign? Beautiful. Line Def Inspector. Yep, done well. Done well. All good. Alright, I think that's 100% everything too. Another successful map. Beautiful. Alright, now we're on the map 4, and it is with many ablutions by the man, Scrangus McBrick, Dad, Jackson R, Mantis Toboggan. And I was kind of rough with him on the feedback, but I feel this is one of his better maps as well. As in the case of Vert, they've come out with some of their better gameplay on these maps. And it was worth it, so... Scrang, if you're listening, I love you, bro. I love what you draw, I love your visuals, and I love to make you tight in your gameplay, because that's about the only area, if you have anything lacking, that is it, bro. And we'll get you there. But this map's kick-ass, the atmosphere. This is the most dungeonistic map of the whole dungeon set, I will say, and atmosphere is 100% success on the project aim. Now I know this map because I tested it. I know it pretty well, so I'm just going to be sort of breezing through it, but it is fucking tough. It killed me a lot. Nice to see a yellow skull instead of a key card. Thank you. I see Stranger stuck to his guns about the five-chain gun of warping. We had a discussion about this. I said, man, just three. You don't want to warp in any more than three. Well, he stuck to his guns, and that's good too. Sometimes you got to stick to your guns. It's good to have a bit of back and forth with your feedback and your mapping and people testing. And don't always just change everything that a dude says. Think about what they're saying and then make a decision whether to change or not. And Skranker's out with his guns there, and it's pretty good. It's pretty good. First time I played, I could just plink him from there, but in second thought, there's not much wrong with five chain gunners warping in. Why the fuck not? This is one of those nice little secrets where it sends you to a part of the map that you'll see later on. You can kind of take out some of the enemies in advance. It's always a nice touch. This is nice. This is definitely the most dungeonistic of all the maps. 100% for theme. As opposed to like myself, who has exactly zero dungeons in his map. Another little secret over here. Where are we? There it is. There's another sneaky low switch. Just like DMDR did. I've never thought about utilizing secrets like that. At the very bottom of the screen. It's not somewhere you're usually paying attention to. It's nice, actually. I might have to try and utilize something in that fashion myself. Very cool traps indeed. Oh no. I love that barrel. I don't like it destroying that early. It helps with the next trap. There we go. Nice, so we've got the key, we're about to go through the yellow door. Oh, I've forgotten something. Almost messed me up. Oh, Oh, that sucks. Start to play a bit too loose. Gotta start focusing again. Now here is a really good fucking setup. I'm just gonna describe it because sometimes you can't tell what's happening. In a minute, there's gonna be like a lift that comes down with a lost soul on it. As soon as you shoot the lost soul, a fucking rev walks in on top of it. It is just fucking clever as fuck. It's a little thing, but I love it. Look at this. Oh, it didn't work that time. There we go, I'll build it all up for nothing. Usually when I play, there's a lost soul here on that lift, I kill it, and that rev warps in, and it's fucking amazing. Maybe it's like a... Maybe it's just a weirdness of the port or whatever. Yeah, I blame Graf. You know, it rained a lot today, it was cold and windy. I blame Graf, man. Graf Zahl is the blame for all that shit, man. You know, the San Francisco 49ers, they lost to the Kansas Chiefs in the Super Bowl yesterday. I blame Graf. He had something to do with that. See that Hell Knight? See that Hell Knight? He just took a big chunk out of my balls. That's Graf's fault. Bloody Graf. Nice. I shouldn't have done that. God, where's that noise coming from? It's starting to get eerie. Oh, nice. I think we're near the end. This is such a wonderful atmosphere, this map. I know I've said it before, I'm gonna say it again. It's fucking... It's eerie, it's good. It's achieved the dungeon goal so much. Now, what's the best way to tackle this to have the most fun? Let me try it this way. Let's wake every fucker up. Yeah, there we go. Whoa! Yep, that was my fault, my bad. Try that again, but with less good at Doom. Ouch indeed, man. Alright, that one lowers the purple armor back in the beginning of that area for the final secret of the map. And we're about to come to the finale. This set's playing pretty well on continuous, I have to say. I know I got a shitload of shells and ammo, but the difficulty's still there, you know? Alright, that's 100% as well. With many ablutions. Beautiful. Alright, I'm just gonna have a quick toilet break as well, and I will be back shortly. So that's map 4, we're halfway through the set, 39 minutes playing time, continuous. It's going to be interesting to, not so much the next map, but Bill's map in slot 6. It's a very finely tuned map, built around the Spider Mastermind gimmick, so it'll be good to see what the continuous does to it. But next I will be playing a DBP debutante mapper's map, which is called Magenta Guildhall, and it's by Sosu. Now Sosu I'm familiar with around the community in various places, he's posting, I've seen a few, but I don't remember ever playing maps by him. So it was quite a nice surprise to see such a clean effort, very cleanly textured, good difficulty. Similar in the way of Walter, how there's not a lot of help early on, like for half a map, so it gives difficulty in this fashion, where you've got to be accurate and not take many shots for the first half of the map, which is pretty good, I like it. I like that kind of difficulty setting. You can still keep with the lower tiers, low mid tier enemies without having to just pump a lot of supplies everywhere, and it's a good style of gameplay I like. It keeps you honest, keeps you in check, keeps you focused, and if you die, well, you're not that far back to start again. I saw Gasp was he was a little upset at the only secret in this map, which he fought and I fought as well. You can only get from the very beginning, and if you miss it, well, that's it. But apparently, there is another way to get it later on. After Sosu replied to Gasp, well, I'm going to check it out and see if there is another access method to the rocket launcher secret at the very start. But I will grab it at the very start just in case I can't figure it out. But let's see. It's always good to upset Gasp. So Sosu gets top marks for that just for giving Gasp shits. Especially because he jumped the gun. But let's see. Let's see if there's some way to get the secret. Whoops. I reckon this map's going to be helped by the continuous a lot. It's pretty tight, just to start. once again, fucking great MIDI track. I love that. The vial running at you and he just disappears. That's a great effect. Yeah, it can play much more freely this map on continuous, even with the lack of health, because you just get tooled up. It's fun. Still, I am taking a bit of unnecessary damage here. I better tighten it up a bit. Ooh, 2% health. There's not much health around this section of the map, so... I'm at the point of one hit, one death now. I'm gonna try and do it, but... it's gonna be bloody tight. Let's see what we can do. Get that health for a start. Oh, and he's gone. Oh, again. I often underestimate how tough the mag fireballs are, how much damage they do. Oh, no good. Totally missed that one. Should be all right now. Fucked up. I thought I had him. Alright, sweet. still on the lookout for the other access to the first secret. Something with an arch file. Okay. I think I know the area. Nah, I'm not sure. It's very medieval. I know it's the track, but the music track, but it's very medieval. This, I got no idea where that other secret entrance is. It's around here. We'll keep going forward. Alright, next up is map 6, which is Guardian of the Mystic Keys by Big Old Billy. My scotch glass is getting low, and Billy's map needs some intensive concentration and focus. I worked out a good route that I like to take when I was doing the PR Boom demos yesterday, so I'm going to attempt it in the same fashion. But this one can kill you a lot. It's fucking, this is razor tight, this fucking map. Razor tight, another classic from Big Old Bill. And give me a couple of minutes to refill my shit and I will be back to do that shit. Thank you. Vertigo. Those are some interesting messages sent to me, bro. Change door sound. Wooden barrel. It's some good communication, bro. No, I'm joking. I know you're making notes to put some final touches for the ID Games release. Yeah, I know. No, use me as a notepad. I like to do the same shit, bro. No, it is a good method. I'm just making fun. No, I love it. This is a good way of memorizing stuff. And then if I don't hear anything from you or see what you were talking to me about, I'll get on your case and go, hey, dude, you said fucking change barrels and change door sound. What the fuck, man? Did you forget? You know, it's good. It's good because I will remind you as well. Accountability. Fucking up, man. Just forget about Siri, man. Ask Glenn Senior. Glenn Senior will, he'll remind you of all the little anal details, like checking for yellow skulls and all the maps, and that they're skulls and not keycards. Making sure all the auto map names are crisp and clear, all that kind of shit. I'm the master of the boring. Sucking down a bit more scotch, having a smoke, and just wondering how many times Bill's map is gonna fuck you right up. This is a fucking great map. Excellent Tomato Man secret, the best one in the whole set. With the dice randomizer, such a good gimmick. Bill is the man of endless ideas, and he just fucking never ceases to amaze me. Wait till he launches the new DVP 21 project, which will be less than 24 hours from now, I'm sure. He's never later than the 4th. The 4th is Bill Day. Whether launching or releasing, it's always on the 4th for Bill. And it's going to be amazing. I don't want to spoil anything here. But it's going to be fucking great. Man, The MIDI selection and this fucking whole project has been excellent. I don't know, when you put a set of headphones on, you really can appreciate it. Like, I've been listening to it all month, and like all the various maps I've been testing and all that kind of, but listening to it today through GZ Doom's got, look, I'm gonna blame Graf for this as well. I blame Graf that he's got a real fucking good music player in his fucking port, because all this shit sounds fucking incredible. I feel like going and whacking it on my big stereo after I finish streaming, yeah? And I don't listen to minis like that usually. So, yeah, man. No, good music selection. Very fucking good music selection. I blame Graf. That's Graf's fault. I'm still trying to suck up the courage to actually enter Bill's map. It's fucking pretty tough. No, I think I've got it nutted out. I did about probably a dozen runs it took me yesterday to make that one good demo in PR Boo. So I've got my route pretty sussed. As long as the monsters play nice exactly when I want them to, it's going to be really fucking smooth. And I know all the secrets now. So, yeah, it's going to be good. Bill's maps to me, it's strange when I play. Like, either I'll ace them the very first time, usually by sheer arse and luck, or it'll take me 100 tries to get through them if I don't ace it that first time. I've got that thing with Bill maps, it's weird. Even ones that should kill me flat out, I can ace it in the very first fucking attempt, but then if I try to do it again, like, I'm just dead, man. Good luck with Bill shenanigans, oh yeah. Yeah, check out on the VOD, man. When I finish this, I will send it to YouTube as usual. I put a video on for ease of use. And yeah, so let's do this shit. Guardian of the Mystic Caves. Oh man, I'm fucked straight away. How do you like that? Ah. Ah, Bill, you evil dungeon master. That chain gonna come from? So this is Bill's Great Tomato Secret. We're gonna enter the, I don't play Dungeons & Dragons, so I don't know the exact terminology for the guy who leads the game, but that's what he's doing here. Now you see those numbers on the roof, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we're gonna go and roll the dice. Whatever number comes up, that's what we're gonna get, and everything else will fuck up, so. We're hoping for a 4, 5, or 6, especially a 6. Let's see, oh, Game Master. Let's see what the Game Master's gonna give us. It's a Revenant. I always get a fucking number 2. How random is this shit, Bill? Honestly, bro. Just want to make sure that fucker does. I haven't always got a 2. I've gotten a 5 and a 6 before. 6 was the best. Alright, now we're going to get the secret with the rocket launcher. Which is there. That's why I killed that Mancubus Golem before. To have easy access to it. I say this a lot, but Bill's fucking outdone himself in this one. This is fucking crazy good. Now our next goal is to get the keys. I'll take care of these guns too. Now we're going to go for the keys. Which is accessed by that switch, lowering the teleporter. Check that shit out. A lot of magic mushrooms. Hang on, I'm still on scotch on my laptop. Let me get a towel. Alright, crisis averted. So now we're back to magic mushrooms. And the mystic key is going up and down all over the place. Now we've got one insane hectic battle. And the attrition of the spider mastermind is taking me down. Let's try that again, but this time remember there's a radiation suit inside the key area. Ah, there we go. Once again, these plasma hands, they just make, they really add the magic ingredient to the whole set. Adds that magic. You feel like you're just shooting magic out at fucking enemies. Alright, I handled that better this time. Let's see. That's the exit. So now we have all the keys, now we want to go and hit all the key switches in all the locations. Gotta watch out for that mastermind, he's always a danger everywhere you are. to Doom myself. Just to get ripped apart by a nymph replacement. Alright. Gosh, shit. I'm pretty trapped here. I don't know how I'm getting out of this. Close, but that's a good. And that's not cool. Alright, I think I've nutted it now. Excuse me. Alright, time to get rid of that mastermind. Here's the secret that activates Crusher to kill him. But you need to have all three key switches activated for that to work. I need some health from anywhere, somewhere. I think all the health is spent. Oh man, that's fucked. Hey, dying camel, how the hell are you, bro? I think we're family now, bro. You're dying camel, I'm dying Glenn. Motherfucker, I keep dying over and over. This exit's not very nice. I think I've exhausted every health supply in the rest of the level. I'm just gonna have to fucking try and get through it somehow. You played many of my maps, bro. I'm sorry, I apologize in advance. I hope you had fun with them, man. I had fun making them. I hope you had fun with them. Alright, I think I can make a rush to the exit now. All the DVP up to 15. So you played the one I led, number 14 after the fall, yeah? Okay, what's happened there? Hang on, sorry. Alright. Up to 15, need to catch up. Oh yeah, they get really good after 15. I have to apologize for 15 because Joe Ilya led that one. Oh no, I'm sorry, we couldn't help it. We didn't have anyone else to lead that month. We had to fucking let Joe do it. You know? I apologize. But yeah, from 16, 17, 18, 19, and then 20, which is what I'm playing now. I'm playing number 20 right now, just released on 2 days ago. I'm doing the Release Candidate 2 version on stream. There's two maps to go now, and it's getting better. I hope... So you didn't play Christmas from last month, the one we released on Christmas Eve. That was fucking awesome. If you haven't played it, save it for Christmas this year, bro. You'll love it. I've got two maps left. I'm about to do Zizzy's map next, number 7. And then my own, which is the boss map. I'm just going to have a quick break because I have to have a quick break and go to the toilet and refill my scotch glass. I'll try and keep it to 2 minutes and we'll go on the map 7, which is Thou Sucketh a Wet Nurse by Mr. Zizzy01. Oh yeah, Camel, we're like wine, bro, the fine wine. We keep getting better all the time because, you know, I'm not just fucking around. We keep at it every month, from the first to the end of the month. We just keep doing it. We keep getting better. The new people keep jumping on board. They keep surprising us, delivering good shit, and it just keeps getting better and better. I've been on board since number 3, and we're up to number 20 now. I just hit like 12 consecutive months of making a map for a DBP. Bill's on a longer streak than that, and we're just addicted to it. Well, we can't even do our own solo projects anymore because we never have any time because we're addicted to the DBP cycle, and they just keep getting better. Halloween Harry, that's Alien Bastards, man, number 13, and that was fucking awesome, man. That is one of the best of the best. Oh man, wait till you play. So you just finished 15. You're up to number 16. Wait till you play that one, man. I'm not gonna spoil it for you, but it's pretty fucking cool. Yeah, I'm just indulging in some of my bad habits of smoking and drinking way too much, but I love it, so give me a couple of minutes, I'm going to delve into Zizzy's map. Now yesterday, when I was doing my PR Boom Pump Level 2 demos, I spent an hour and a half on fucking this map just to get the one successful run I got, because this map has a gimmick of ghost monsters. Now I'm playing in GZ Doom, the ghost monsters aren't going to work, but the map isn't any less tougher for that fact, although I won't take an hour on it, I can say that. But Zizzy's a very cerebral mapper, a lot of his stuff has gimmicks, but they're not just fucking cheap, they're very expensive gimmicks. And I'm not going to play it like live now if Ghost Monsters will be here all fucking night. So it's going to be the GZ Doom style. But one of these days, play this map in the correct intended port and challenge yourself. It's really fucking cool. And then, after I knock off Zizzy's map, I'll get onto my own. Hopefully, I will not be that drunk I can't stand anymore, but I'm getting close. Now for Zizzy's map, he has a one-time secret. It's one of those door closes in 30 seconds from the start of the map secrets. So when I was working out a route yesterday, I decided to go for that first because it lowers invulnerability and helps a lot in some sections. So I'm going to rush to that as fast as I can, so I can have the invulnerability at the stage I wanted in the map. and it's going to be cool. And I'm not going to die 100 times, I guess. But there's a really cool run. If you go to the Boomer Boards release thread for DVP 20, there's a whole set of comp level 2 demos I've released. And it's a pretty good demo. Pretty action-packed. And here we go with that shit. Those sucker fowlers. Apparently you can enable ghost monsters in GZ Doom, but I don't want to because this fucking kills you to death when you got it. Maybe another day. I spent literally an hour and a half fucking trying to make a good run on this yesterday. So let's say the intermission text. You've seen so much chaos in the last few hours. So much death, so much carnage. After the showdown with the Spider Mastermind, you feel a surge of energy. It's as though your experience has culminated in stronger abilities. Wiping the sweat from your brow, you walk through the teleport. After a thunderous crack, you hear an even more terrifying sound. You see ghosts ahead. Roll for initiative. Well, not in this playthrough, thank God. Alright, so I got a dash to get this fucking, I got a dash to get this 30-second secret straight off the bat. I'm gonna pistol start this because 22 of health, I just ain't gonna cut it. There we go. Clean start. I've already fucked up the timing, I think. Yep. Oh, get out the fucking way. I'm dead. Nah, I missed it. I fucking missed it. Kill me. Where are you? Kill me. There we go. Oh my god. The handling's so much different to PR, bro. That's it. Nailed it that time. Alright, you're gonna hit that one again to get the invulnerability. We're gonna save that for later on at a choice spot. Sweet. Key here to save that megasphere for later. Try not to take too much damage in this section. which ain't gonna happen. Now I'll nail that invulnerability secret. This part's pretty fucking rough. Alright, this is the part where the ghost monsters will fuck you up if you got it enabled. Which I don't, thankfully. Now you have these NPCs, these voodoo doll player one stars. You've got to nail all of them to lower that rocket launcher. Which you absolutely need with the ghost monsters, because it's the only way to kill them. This one gives you a lot of rocket ammo. Well, it didn't in this case. Another thing that doesn't work in GZ. And this is the fourth of the NPCs that lower the rocket launcher. Bang. So since I got no ghost monsters, I guess I will go straight to the exit. This is a pretty gnarly fight as well. Nothing to sneeze at. I might clean up the arachnotrons while I'm here though. Alright, and now time for the exit. Once again, if you're playing in boom ports, you'll be swarmed by ghost monsters right now, and it's not that bloody easy. Even that's not easy, Jesus. Zizzy is an evil, evil man. I'll tell you, he's a sadistic motherfucker. And that's the exit. Marvelous. Alright, now we're heading up to the boss map, which is my very own. It's called Electric Kingdom. I think I'm going to do this on Pistol Start as well, but just hang on. My dog's looking at me like she's going to eat me. I'm just going to quickly feed her. I'll be back in 2 minutes to do the final map. Ella! Dinner time, come on. Come on, girl. Yeah. Put your fangs away. I fed you. It's all good. Keep going. Good dinner. That's it, girl. Alright, I'm nearly back for the final map. Two more minutes and we'll come to the conclusion of this final journey. Alright. Now we're about to go into map 8 of D&D Dungeons and Demons, which is my very own Electric Kingdom. And I'm going to play at Pistol Start, so I can play it the way it's intended. Here we go. Now, I love arachnotrons. I love to place arachnotrons at a very large distance, because I love to see that stream of plasma just fucking fly all over the screen. And there's a lot of it in this map. This secret little crate raises a little bit of rock over there. Now, anyone who knows me, they know I love Doom boats. I don't know why. Someone actually posed the question, why do we love Doom boats, the other day? I've got no fucking idea. We just fucking do. So, boats! I see my agility is leaving me. That's alright, I'll still survive. Early Solstice secret. Which leads us to the tomato secret. Thank you. Now, yesterday when I played this on Comp Level 2 demos, I just did it the normal way without activating an early secret. I'm going to activate the early secret today. Get by jumping here. There's two ways into this secret. I did the other way yesterday on the demo, but this is the early way. Died on my own map. That's when you know it's a good map. If you die on your own map, you know you've made a good one. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. Thank you. Tell me I'm back here. Ooh. The other way to access the secret with the BFG. Hang on. The other way to access that secret with the BFG, there's a shoot switch straight there. Behind the Kako head. You hit that, that door will open. You can get in here, get the BFG. Now we're getting up to the exit, the second phase on the map. Now we go to phase two, which is the slaughter map part of the map. Now, I'm not big on slaughter maps, but I made this big ass fucking architecture in space here, and there was really no option. I had to do it. And we're in need of a boss map, so here we go. So you got these four switches, which raise the circle in the middle, which is a lift. hitting the four switches will rise that circle to the right height, so you can jump onto the this purple fountain over here to access the next part of the map. Now we're ready to access the second phase of the map. And now it gets full on. Motherfucker. Quick. Sorry if I stopped talking, I'm just trying to focus on getting through this little crazy ass fucking battle. Fuck, I did it in one try yesterday.
Mm-hmm. motherfucker.
Well, that is done. pick up the last few items. So I set up this ending to have a very big explosive finale. So you do that by this. This will also open the way back out. If you want to go back outside there again. For any reason. Maybe you missed something. Want to get 100%. Otherwise, you run over this little triangle here. And it starts the exit chain. It's game over. And we enter the credit map, which I whipped together just as a temporary kind of thing, but it's ended up being pretty cool and most likely will stay permanent. Basically, you got your comrades. So the whole premise of the set is that you're just some space marines stuck on some backwater Deimos base, and you're bored and having a game of Dungeons and Demons, or Dungeons and Dragons, or whatever, to try and liven things up. And the resulting maps were the result of the Dungeons and Dragons game that these guys had. You see the dice. They all add up to 20, for DBP 20. So there's 4, 6, 16, 18, 20. The mysterious, so far benevolent tomato man, sitting at his desk with his dice in hand like the grandmaster. And if we hit the switches, we'll see our mappers' names, along with a scene that represents their map. So the DBP 20 lead is the choice, brah, Vertigo. And that is his. Walter Confalonieri. Those nice blocky blocks into the void. Zizzy. With that outstanding statue. That is from the start of his map. I really love that piece of architecture. I feel that represents him pretty well for this set. Skrangus McBrickdad with his exit pyramid. Very nice in that space. Big bad old fucking Billy. The Guardian of the Mystic Keys, which was the mastermind, of course, with his keys raising up and down like in a very mystical fashion. DMDR, the Seller of the Stargazer, with his bookshelves and spiderwebs. I like that, just sort of floating there. Looks pretty nice. Sozu. I really love that setup from his map, and it was nice just to grab it and dump it in the void for his credit spot. And last, but certainly very fucking least, is the supreme cunt of all cunts. The wonderful gentleman who is always polite and never rude and never has sworn in his life, fuck. Glenn fucking Senior. With my boat of doom. I originally made this boat for DBP 11, Lily White Lilith, and as usual, when I have a nice scenery, I like to recycle it in prefab style. And this is from there, dressed up in the DBP 20 garb, and it's very nice. And there you have it, that is Dungeons and Demons, my people. Another fine installment in the never-ending, ever-continuing Duma Boards Project series. And I'm just wondering if I should play something else. Since I'm already set up, I might just go and have a piss and think about if I can be fucked playing something else. If you want to stick around, be my guest. It's all chill here in the house of flowing drinks and rocking tunes. DB Crew for life, motherfuckers! Speaking of which, I'm going to put on another DVP bomb track by the master MC, Big Old Billy, while I'm having this little intermission, trying to make up my mind. Don't touch that dial.
Doing numbers, plus we got some new shit dropping Christmas Eve. Knowing
it's sad, that's a DB philosophy. My team is different, we phobos anomalies. Snub us and stick the apology right up your ass, that's a free colonoscopy. Man, I saw your map was a disaster. Drop your projects faster before we shoot you right up like some damn alien bastard. No fishes in a pond full of guppies. Came on the scene, blew it up like Cuffy. Bitching and moaning these haters. Forever be scared and alone on some PvP 17. Evenings I'm scheming with my evil crew. In my monster condo, rock a silver color, fire blue. Them boys nice like John Romero's hair. We dropping classics, son. 40 had a dream, we made it gleam like Umbral Platinum. Crew shit, crew shit, crew shit. What you really know about this doom shit? Come around the place, we're getting ruthless. My team on that, got something to prove shit. Crew shit, crew shit, crew shit. What you gonna do against the whole clique? You can bust a limit, we remove it. Crew shit, crew shit. Crew shit, crew shit, crew shit. What you really know about this doom shit? Come around the place, we're getting ruthless. My team on that, got something to prove shit. Crew shit, crew shit, crew shit. What you gonna do against the whole clique? You can bust a limit, we remove it.
To say, but nothing comes out with a move that lifts. Man, it's sad but true. The motherfuckers have forgot about the TV crew.
Alright, that's gonna be it from Glenn Zinger tonight. The House of Flowing Drinks and Rocking Tunes is signing out and going private from this point onwards. I hope you enjoyed the show. And what you'll enjoy more is download DBP20, Dungeons and Demons. Play this shit, yo. It's fucking rocks. Peace out. Cunts.